It's my distinct privilege and pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Isaac Nelson. Dear friends, when God in love created the world, he made man and woman in his own image and bonded them together in marriage. Through this blessed union of husband and wife, God established the family, provided for the physical and spiritual welfare of children, and fostered the peace and stability of society. God intended marriage to bring loving companionship to the people of his world, but because of sin, the joy of marriage was soon overcast with sorrow, and the harmony of family life was shattered by strife. Out of love, God sent his son Jesus to die on the cross to take away the sins of all people. Everyone who believes in Jesus receives forgiveness and is enabled by the Holy Spirit to live in peace and joy. God's love for you is boundless. He commands you in response to his love to love each other. Love is forgiving and enduring. Love shows itself in truth and faithfulness, in thoughtfulness and understanding, in patience and kindness. Marriage furnishes a unique opportunity to put this love into practice. The pattern for Christian marriage is an intimate union of Christ and his church, which the Apostle Paul depicts in Ephesians chapter 5. After urging believers, first of all, to submit to one another out of reverence for Christ, he makes this application for Christian spouses. Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. It is reverence for Christ on the part of husband and wife that lays the foundation of Christian marriage. You have come here today to be united in marriage, which consists in your mutual consent, sincerely and freely given. You are now invited to declare this intent in the presence of God and these witnesses. Isaac Nelson, will you take Allison Connell to be your wife? Will you be guided by the counsel and direction God has given in his word and love your wife as Christ loved the church? Will you be faithful to her, cherish her, support her, and help her in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Oh. Allison Connell, will you take Isaac Nelson to be your husband? Will you be guided by the counsel and direction God has given in his word and submit to your husband as the church submits to Christ? Will you be faithful to him, cherish him, support him, and help him in sickness and in health as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Join your right hands and make your promises to each other. I, Isaac.
I, Isaac.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
Take you, Allison.
Take you, Allison.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I, Allison. In the presence of God and these witnesses.
In the presence of God and these witnesses.
Take you, Isaac.
Take you, Isaac.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Exchange rings as a symbol of the lifelong commitment and abiding love which you as husband and wife have promised each other. Allison, receive this ring.
Allison, receive this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
Isaac, receive this ring.
Isaac, receive this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
By their promises, Isaac and Allison have bound themselves together in marriage before God and these witnesses. Therefore, I declare that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. It is my distinct privilege and pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Isaac Nelson.
Usually lasts as long as he's able to make love to his wife. So I'd like to thank you guys for coming out tonight. I'm here all night. Hold on. Okay.
Second win?
No, when Isaac asked me to be the best man, I really was truly honored. And I was truly honored that the seven other guys he asked before said no. So now I'll get to the real speech. Okay. Isaac, you're very handsome. You're the best looking big brother. You can't read your handwriting. Okay. No, but really, guys, dude, you're my big little brother. I love you guys to death. You got yourself a good woman. Take care of her. Ali, welcome to the family. We've got a big family, as you can see.
Yeah!
Just welcome to the family. You guys, I hope you guys have many, 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 many years of happiness and just loving each other, okay? Remember, that's the most important thing, love each other. All right? Welcome to the family. We used to shower together, it's okay. All right, let's go ahead and raise a glass to Isaac and Allison. To help and happiness. Love you guys. This is your night.
My brother and I worked to make a Welcome Baby Allison banner to celebrate the arrival of Allison into our lives. And ever since then, it's been a celebration. We have worked very hard together. My brother wasn't able to be here tonight, and I have worked very hard to raise the wonderful woman, young woman that she is today. Mom and Dad may have had something to do with that too. But really, when she came home from the hospital, I was so happy to have a real life baby doll that I could comb her hair, I could feed her. And while our family may not be as big as Isaac's is, we certainly know how to hold our own. So to each of you, holding your own while still compromising, we all love you. Keep communication open, stay true to yourselves, stay true to your families, and you've got a whole room of fans who are ready to support you. We love you.
Ready, ladies.
distant bathroom.